woman that's looking for a man for a relationship, a problem is not a problem until you call it a problem. Fair enough, I'm coming. If you call it a problem, you want a way out, whatever your issue might be, you are struggling with your relationship, please come. Don't wait. That's how to know a good woman. A good man and woman, they look for a solution to their problem. Solution not in the street shouting. Not in the social media, you are exposing your husband to the whole world. Not in social media, you are exposing your wife to the whole world. No. We have to be play a very skillful game. Not give a very skillful, tactful way to handle issues and home. Whatever you expose yourself to the wrong people. Before you know it, your name is on the sky. That's what we are talking about.
Yeah.
So to be somebody minded, make you to be a good man. If you are a reverend somebody, reverend means just honorable somebody. Honorable. A honorable man will not be expected to be lying outside. You can't expect a man to be stealing outside. You can't expect a man to be sleeping around outside. You can't expect a man that have a wife, you are having concubine, you have a girlfriend. It's likewise to the women. That, what other way do you think our viewer can get the answer to know who is a good man and a good woman in their relationship or in any relationship?
We are still talking from the same background, from the same book of Titus.
Yeah.
I will be reading from chapter 2, verse 4 this time around. It says, chapter 3, verse 3. Old woman, likewise had to reverent in behavior, slanderers or slave to, sorry, what am I saying? Where am I? Old woman, likewise had to be reverent in behavior, not slanderer or slave to too much wine. They are to teach what is good. Should I go forward or should I let me go forward? They are also train the young women to love their husbands and children. I will stop from here. I know 5 talking about to be self-controlled, pure, working at home, kind and submissive to your husband. So let me
break it down.
Let me break it down to the question that you asked me. You say a good woman. How do I know a good woman? A good woman, which is it could be an elderly woman, and it could be a mature woman who has been married or not married, but at least you are mature enough to understand or to identify what is right and what is wrong. So what you should do, you shouldn't be going around talking to people, speaking negative things about people, or let me use a common word, gossiping, and all that doesn't make you to be a good woman. A good woman should be the one that will prepare his home. A good woman shouldn't be the one. I know years ago, back home, I knew of some men when they are going out and they will say to their wife, please, when I'm coming today, let me have house to enter. That means, don't take me to the community.
So that what you call a ikegbe, you know.
Yes.
Ikegbe is saying that family.
Maybe family meeting or community meeting.
Yeah. Why? For those who have ear. Yeah.
Why? Because whenever they go out and when they are coming out, it's always going to be a different story. Mm-hmm. Is that their wife has fighting with somebody here,
right,
or fighting with the other person here, or they are come to say your wife has said this against me, or your wife has done this against me, mm-hmm, and with all that, no man will be happy to see his wife each and every time he's not at home or coming home. There's always one problem to another. Either this one will come, the other one will come, or the other one will come. Community people, at some point, they may even be calling their names. Mm-hmm. You know, sometimes the person may not even know it, and they are calling their name based on what they know.
The attitude.
Even here at some point, where we are, you know, when the police identify you for a particular thing, probably you are stealing or you break a car or whatever. So when similar thing happen in the community, they will first of all come to you to ask you, did you know what happened to so-and-so? And that's because of you know, they have known you, so your identity, your attitude is not good. So in order for you to be a good woman, you must stay clear from some of these things.
Slandering should be a thing of the past.
Yeah.
Good. So
not just only in your home, but with your community, and which means everything that is coming out of your mouth have to be what is edifying, what is good, and what bring, what lifts somebody up, and what empowers people. And it could even be, it's like it will be a medication to heal other people who are going through issues.
Okay.
And another thing again, I really love here. See, and also train the young women to love their husbands and children. Also train the young women. So what would that? This is one of the things I really like this place, because this is part of the reason why we have teen and twin relationships here.
So ideally, a good woman should train their children to love their husband, love their children.
Of course, exactly. Because this is some of the things that is lacking today in the society or in the community. And that's why we hear so much divorce. Because training have not been in place. So because of that, a lot of people are, you know, doing things that may not be actually right. You see that, like as I said, let me not go far. So this is why I love teen and twin relationship. I love this place, because it's one of the reasons why teen and twin relationship is happening in this place. You know, when you train up your children the way they will grow up, and it's hard for them to depart away from them. So I'm not preaching, but what I'm simply saying. But what I'm simply saying, here in twin and twin relationship, we are teaching the children, the younger ones, how to love one another, how to do what is right, how to go away from the negative side, how to do what is positive instead of negative. And imagine these children will grow up like this, or how to play, love your brothers and your sister in the same home, and respect to your parents and your brothers and sisters. So when they grow up in this aspect, and when they get to a place of marriage, they will also display the same attitude that they have learned from the
while they are young. Good.
And the reason why there are many divorces as a result of many people have not been told why they were young. So we all grow up and pick things that we know, but some are lucky that they will pick a right attitude from their parents, and they will also do it. But not everybody is able to do that, and the children will likely to pick the wrong one from their parents. So parents who are wise enough, the negative things that they are doing, they don't do it in the presence of their children. So when their children don't see, they can't pick it. But when they do the right thing in the presence of their children, their children. But what about those who do not have
opportunity?
So this is why life and relationship is teen and twin relationship is very important that we are doing, because we know that the children will grow up to become a better one.
One day.
Because so you know. It's just like, let me give a bit of example of a somebody, I don't want to call name anyway, but somebody that I have met, or you know, and she told me she would never go into a relationship, into marriage, and I asked her why. She said that because all the time, she see her mother arguing with her father,
fighting and all that,
and because she cannot take that anymore, so why will I? We should go into marriage. At the end of the day, you know, the relationship break up anyway, so we just want to stay with her mother all along, and you know, be supporting her mother. There's no need for her to go into a relationship that at the end of the day she will break up. So, and this is why, again, I will say it's very important for teen and twin to be learning from all these things, because I think she was about 19 years old, person who was talking to me. And this is what she had learned, and this is what she had had in her mind. Imagine that if she be in an environment where, you know, she never picked something like that from her parents. So she will never see that marriage is a bad thing or whatever. And even though she go in tomorrow now, what she's going to play in her mind is that, well, after all, my mom divorced my dad, so if anything goes on, they can also do, because the love and the love has never been there from the father or from the mother. The father is unable to love the mom and love the family, just like this place is telling us to train our children how to love our husband. Or the woman are unable to love the man and love the children, and so that they can breed their home
together
in a lovely way. So this is the reason why this is happening. And she signed up to say, I will marry, because it never worked for my parents, so it's not going to work for her.
Well, and I think for that, the blame is coming from both the person and the parent. Thank God for the foundation I had, you know. I never see my mom shouting to challenging my father, or my father challenging. But everything has been equal. Maybe they have their own team behind us, I don't know. But thank God, you know, I picked all every good thing from my parents. What I saw them doing, that's what I am doing. I even enhanced on my own. Because maybe that time is not the current time we are now, you know. So I never see my father cooking anyway. till tomorrow, I never see my father cooking. So because maybe he has so many people that could do the cooking. These days, you know, some will say, the woman will say, you have to cook. It's 50-50. I don't understand. You know, it has to be inbuilt for a man to cook. If you are available to do the cooking, it shouldn't be way on the woman. That's one of the things to know if you are a good man. You build your home. Women are not machines that you use like that. But the woman shouldn't take the upper hand. Say, you know, let's balance things. That's what I'm saying. So if a man is soberly minded all the time in a man's area, you see that this little nagging and all that, it will not be fine in the home.
I think, in my perspective, out of one of the area where you have to know a good woman, it's also mean that, you know, you respect. But I think let me interfere with a man. I think it's also good that when a man sees his wife struggling, you shouldn't wait for the man to tell you, come and help me. I'm carrying something and it's heavy, and you see me carrying that thing, and you should come with a willing mind to help me. Mm-hmm. Or maybe sometimes your attention might not be drawn to it, but when the woman also say, can you help me please? I think it's also a good thing for you to do it. Again, it has to do with the tone that you are using to talk. If you did not say it in the right way, mm-hmm. then again, it may not as well be good. So these are some of the things we have to consider. Being a good woman, when you are asking for help, when you are asking for help from your husband or to support you, and you have to come in a polite way, or in a way, is a way you will put it, and the man will want to support. And if you are a good man, when you see your wife is struggling to do something, or for example, your wife is at work, coming back, and you know that, oh, I can just boil rice, for example, or I can just help her to maybe tidy up a little thing. I think that's working hand in hand. It's also another good thing, which means it's not 50-50, but it's like working as a team, supporting one another. And in that, the children will also see you doing the same thing. And the children will also grow up, pick the same attitude. And in that way, we are all building in love, not in quarrel, not in fighting, not 50-50, but working as a team.
Anyway, thank you so much for watching our program. Mm-hmm. We just give an answer to the question that comes from person like you, our viewers. He said, who is a good man and a woman in a relationship? Mm-hmm. Thank God we don't have our answer, but our answer from the word of God, which the God that created the heaven and earth. So mm-hmm. the Bible has given the answer in the book of Titus, mm-hmm. chapter 2, verses 1 to verses 5. Mm-hmm. That's what gives answer to who is a good man and a good woman. Mm-hmm. One more time, if you find this program very interesting to you, please share this video and let other people hear about it. And then we want you to give us your question so that you can as well handle your question here. You know, remember, for those who are seeking for a life partner, for a serious relationship, the matchup program is still going on. We have a list of men and women seeking themselves. Please, as you said, be visible, don't be invisible, so that we can match you up. If you do that, you will see that there's a blessing to live in singleness, to be a married person, to be a couple. So far, I hope you enjoy our program. Please subscribe and let us know your comments. Thank you for your time, and God bless you.